on?
Yes.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the March Town Hall for, from the Asian American Arts Alliance. For those of you who are new, this is a monthly gathering. We do this every first Tuesday of the month. Know that any first Tuesday of the month, at 10 o'clock, you're welcome. Whether or not you buy RSVP, we prefer if you do, but you're always welcome to come. Whether or not you buy RSVP to speak, you'll get a chance to speak at the end too, even if you haven't sent us a message. The Town Hall is a program we've been doing since February of last year. We've had about, I think about 650 people since we started, more than 350 pitches, countless connections. Thanks to all of you who submitted a survey last month. That was greatly enlightening. So we're very thankful to our partners here at RE for having us again. The structure of Town Hall is very simple. People who've signed up get 2 minutes, 2 minutes all inclusive for their pitch. And if you have a website or some media, we can play that while you're speaking. But after 2 minutes, I am still learning with this new tool, but I ring this bell. I used to have a sign that said time up, but a lot of you used to sort of turn away from me, and so I decided to use this. I'm still clutching this very carefully because I'm still learning. It's really in the spirit of the respect of other people that we keep our pitches short. It's also good practice to get a pitch in a way that is concise so that people can grab the information. If you have not signed up for a pitch, your name is not on the pitch at the end, we reserve time for micro pitches. And those are 30-second announcements. So I'll ask anybody who still wants to say something to come up and say something. So I think we'll start very briefly with a quick round of introductions. If in a few seconds you can tell us who you are and where you're from, and if you've brought something to eat, please let us know what you brought. And so again, I'm Nico, I'm the program director at the Alliance, and I'll ask Mariko to start, and then maybe we can go around this way.
I'm Mariko, I'm the program assistant at the Asian American Arts Alliance.
Hi, I'm Yuna Hong. I'm a documentary filmmaker. I'm going to pitch my upcoming screening today.
I'm Hollis from Dance Theater Workshop, and I'm going to give you a little preview of some of the shows that we have coming up.
I'm Bora Yun. I'm an experimental sound artist.
I'm Ashok Sinha. I'm a photographer in New York, and I got munchkins again.
My name is Kyoko. I came from London.
Hi, my name is Rie. I'm a dancer. I do jazz dance and hip hop and then African dance. And then also I'm working with New Khalid Company.
Hi, I'm Christine Toy Johnson, actor, playwright, filmmaker. I'll be speaking later.
Hi, it's Anwar Hussein. I'm an artist and painter, Long Island City area.
Work is about the secret lives of animals, and I'm going to be talking later. And I brought the melon papers.
Oh, me? My name is Hidemi Takagi. I'm a photographer. I'm originally from Japan, and I live in Brooklyn.
I'm Jessica Vosberg from New York Foundation for the Arts Immigrant Artists Project.
My name is Sami Bushimais. I'm an Arabic musician, violinist, vocalist. I direct an ensemble called Sikrayat.
My name is TJ from Tokyo. I'm a body balance therapist. I'm going to stay 2 months this time. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Mana Hashimoto. I'm originally from Japan, living in Queens. I'm a dancer and choreographer. And we brought smiley sesame bowl from Chinese bakery.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. My name is Seema, and I work at the Department of Consumer Affairs Office of Financial Empowerment. I'm
going to
get into why I fit in a little bit.
I'm Jorge Ortol. I'm the executive director for my care company. I'll be pitching the next show soon.
Hi, my name is Kenji Nakano. I'm a part of Taikoza, the Japanese drumming group. I'm going to talk about the performance coming up this weekend and also workshops.
I'm Janice Wan, the interim executive director and first day on the job.
Hi. I'm Jen Shu. I'm a vocalist, composer, I have ongoing shows forever. So, I
I'm John Lamb. I'm with Curious Rock Theater Company. I'm the theater administrator. And I'm pretty much just going to talk about our season.
I'm Alvin Chen. I'm also with the Curious Rock Theater Company. And I will talk about the same things.
This is Louise Brooks. I'm with the Revision Department.
I'm Kelly Bausch. I'm here from the Field, the Artist Service Organization.
I'm Brian Chamberlain.
I'm Martin, I'm a 3D artist animator.
I'm Simi, I'm with Lotus Music and Dance, and I love cookies, and I have flyers here about some folks.
My name is Adarsh Alphonse, I'm with the Harlem School of the Arts, and it's my second time at the Town Hall, and again, I'm not funny.
You can share mine.
Okay. I'm Anissa Ng, I'm a visual artist. I do installation and painting. My installation is more related to my interest in unconscious mind, and my painting is more related to my identity as a Hong Kong artist, which was a British colony, and now it's part of China.
I'm Golnar Dili. I'm a visual artist. I'm doing a residency at the Lower East Side Print Shop right now, and I'm very happy to see you.
My name is Peter Yip, and I'm a graphic artist and an educator, and I'm going to be talking about my dolls today. This is the first program that I got from the Town Hall meeting.
I'm Susan Massett, and I'm here today to invite people to a very unique conference gathering of international gathering people from all over the world who are exploring performance as a social activity for social change. It's taking place at the end of September, but we would like to participate. So.
Well, thanks everyone. I think we'll start. We'll go right in, and I'm going to ask our good friend. Oh, sorry. Sorry about that.
My name is Angie Wei. I'm the director of the Asian Women Giving Circle. It's my first time here as part of the circle, but I know representatives have come in the past. I'll be talking about our open and current request for proposal process to support Asian women-led social change projects by using the tools of art as a medium for social change.
Hi, I'm Adam Natale. I'm the Director of Membership and Program Development with Fractured Atlas, and I'll talk about that a little later.
I'm Alexandra Gray. I'm the Director of Development of Fractured Atlas.
Bonnie Stein, the Director of GO Productions, a nonprofit art services organization.
So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our good friend. She hasn't been here for a while. She's back in town to start us off with this short performance. Please welcome Jen Chu.
Thank you. Unfortunately, I have a recording session right after this, so I'm going to just start to pass this around. Is it on? Or I can just film. Very quickly, this is an instrument from Taiwan. And although I'm mostly a jazz musician and contemporary composer, I've been researching musics around the world when I can. So Taiwan was one spot. My next project is East Timor, which is where my mom is from. So it's all part of the same thing.
way I'd sing. If I knew they'd let me repent for the rice I stole. I'm a good man, if only they knew. I could show my face and say my name. I'd be free to think my thoughts and never be.
Coach and consultant. So I coach executive directors and emerging leaders throughout the country, so Pan-Asian executive leaders. And when this opportunity came up, I said, what a better way to apply what I've done throughout my career in corporate and business life than to help the artistic community, individual artists, and arts organizations to become a vibrant and credible part of our city and community, and to really open up access to opportunities for you and to provide you with the tools, resources, and ways to expand access, ultimately helping you become successful. So what we need from you is to become successful as an alliance is for you to keep coming back to the town hall, to share feedback, and to spread the word about the alliance, because our partnership in the community is really a critical part to our success. So thank you for coming to the town hall. Our programs are really in great hands under Nico's leadership with Mariko, Masako Drew, and also Christy Dam, our development assistant, who was here earlier. So we have a great team. Our board of directors is very engaged in the search for our next executive director. I'm here on an interim basis to ensure organization stability and to bring new insights. So your feedback is really critical in terms of building our future. So feel free to reach out to us. We are here to help you and we're committed to your mission. Thanks.
Okay, Okay, I'd like to invite Christine Toy Johnson, followed by Caroline Sun, followed by Seema Shah.
Thank you. Good morning. It's full house today. That's exciting. I have passed out these cards on your chairs. It's a fundraising concert and a DVD release celebration of our film Transcending the Wat-Mississauga Story that a lot of you have been following. We're finally releasing it March 22nd. We're really excited. There is a $25 door charge, but it includes a chance to win these fabulous prizes we have, including a personal training session, some gift certificates, an in-home massage, all kinds of neat things. We're also going to be making our film festival April 11th. And I got some exciting news yesterday that a play of mine called Internal Bleeding is going to theater at the end of March as well. I'm excited about that. Through various connections here, I think, I was telling Nico that I got a grant from the Lower Manhattan Cultural Council to do a one-night-only, all-Asian-American concert version of Once on This Island, which we will be doing May 16th, somewhere in Manhattan, I don't know where yet, in conjunction with Actors Equity Association Asian Heritage Month celebration. It will be free, and I'll come back and let you know about that. And speaking of equity, I know that there are not a lot of actors here, but I'm putting this out there. I'm running for president of the union this year. And thank you. And if elected, I would be the first Asian American and only the second person of color in the 100 years history of the union. So and thank you. Thanks for putting it out there. You know, if you know actors and they pay attention, please vote. And the only other thing, I just want to get the word out about this. If anyone is interested, there's some fabulous Broadway singers that are going to be singing and a lot of fun. And I know that people are here from Fractured Atlas, and I just want to give a shout out because you're our fiscal sponsor and you've been fabulous. And so I encourage everyone to look them up too. Thank you very much.
Good morning, I'm Caroline Sun. I'm a painter, and my work is about the secret lives of animals. Many of you already actually got an email from me yesterday, and those who haven't will probably get one from me. Go to the next. Yeah, sure, I'm a little squished up. Thank you. You can switch the video. Okay. This doesn't cut in my 2 minutes, does it? No. Make sure it's all right. Okay. Normally my work, as I said, is about the secret lives of animals, but actually this one is more political than what I usually do. What happened was, most of you remember the miracle on the Hudson, where the plane landed safely in the Hudson, which was really good. But the problem was, a lot of people thought, well, it's all the birds' fault. So basically what they did, I don't know if you know this, they went and killed all the Canadian geese for 5 miles around each of the airports in this area. And it cost $50 a bird, so I don't know how many birds were killed, so it was also expensive. And the sad thing about it was, I go to the parks a lot, and we had seen a lot of parent birds with their babies, and it was molting season, so that's why they could catch them. So sure enough, all the birds were gone, and then about a month or so later, there were birds back again. Well, because they had grown their feathers in, and birds from other areas came in, so it was totally a useless endeavor. So I painted this sort of in tribute to the birds who died, and I call it Safer Skies. Anyway, this piece is being shown as part of a three-venue exhibition in Long Island City. You can go to the next slide. This one is specific venues are the Clock Tower Building and the Holiday Inn Manhattan View. I also installed the exhibition that's at the Clock Tower as well. So we're having reception on Thursday night from 6 to 8 p.m. All three sites are within blocks of each other, so you can come visit, have some free food, and enjoy some great art. I'm leaving some cards over there. I wish I brought more. I didn't realize it was going to be such a full house. But thank you very much.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. I'm not a mic person. I'm just going to try to project out into the space. I work at the Department of Consumer Affairs Office of Financial Empowerment. Has anyone heard of us ever before? No. Oh, really? Yes. Most people, when they think of DCA, they think of the Cultural Arts Organization, the Department of Cultural Affairs. That is not us.
But for the first time in our 40-year history, we're partnering with the Department of Cultural Affairs, among many Harlem arts-based organizations, including The Field and Fractured Atlas, to do what we're calling a personal resources, a personal finance fair for artists. It's happening on Saturday, March 6th, at the Dwyer Center in Harlem. It's on 123rd Street and St. Nicholas Avenue. I have flyers here, and they're sort of in the back over there by the food, which none of which I bought, but some of which I purchased in, to basically help artists and working independent workers balance the needs of their finances and how they use credit to finance their work and how they use other sources of income, and they have to stretch that dollar sort of really, really, really far. And so we're working to put on a resource day, a fair that gets people sort of thinking about their finances and thinking about ways they can help finance their art, what they should do during tax time, what they should do. They have credit problems, debt problems, problems that people face. Regular people bring this one for artists. Again, it's on Saturday, 12 to 5, at the Dwyer Cultural Center in Upper Manhattan. And I really hope you can tell friends, family, your networks about the event. And I'd be happy to send along a PDF of the flyer if you guys would like it. Any questions?
Do I need to sign up?
No. Totally open. Just come in. That's all you need to do. No sign up, no RSVP, no nothing. Thank you.
I'd like to invite Jorge, Tomayi, Bonnie Stein, and followed by Peter Yip.
I should stand here, right? Or should I?
Actually, you don't have any cues.
Sorry?
Jorge, you don't have any slides, do you?
No, I didn't bring any today. Hi, I'm Jorge, the executive director from Mayi Theater Company. We are the oldest, one of the oldest, we're 21 years old, Asian American theater companies in the country. And by the way, I forgot to mention, I did bring some turrón, which is a Spanish delicacy made of almonds and honey. It's hard candy, it's in the middle of a table someplace. Anyway, what I'm here for is to pitch the theater company, our upcoming show, and the Writers Lab. We have the Mayi Writers Lab, which is the biggest collective of Asian American theater playwrights in the country. And going forward, and from some time in the past, we've only been producing work from the lab. And our next production, which is Rescue Me, I think I've given you postcards, and there's more on the table, is written by one of our labbies, Michi Baral, who's Japanese American. And it's a takeoff on the Iphigenia story, Iphigenia and Tauris by Euripides. We've got some fabulous artistry. David Greenspan, the virtuoso downtown artist, is playing Artemis, the goddess. And we've got Jennifer Ikeda, who did Top Girls recently. She's doing Iphigenia. Julian Barnett, who is Hapa, is doing wonderful choreography and acting as well as Orestes. The direction is by Filipino-American Loy Arsena. So it's and then we've got all the colors of the rainbow in the cast as well and in the design team. So I'd like for you all to come, and I think we're all going to get an email with all our addresses.
Yes.
What I'd like to do is for everybody in the room, I will respond and give you a code so you can get a discount if you buy tickets for it. We play at the Ohio Theater, which is going to close permanently in August. We're playing from March 23 through April 18. And I urge you to come. Have a wonderful time. What I also want to impress upon everyone here who's interested in having theater as a networking, as an advocacy event, as a fundraising event, to contact me, because we do group rates and we do wholesale packages where groups can come and have a reception before or after the show, have a Q&A with the artists, mingle with each other, and urge their donors and their board of directors to come up with the checkbooks and give their cause more money. So we're trying to more and more use our shows as a fundraising event for other organizations who are interested in them. Thank you, Nico. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Stein. I can't stand microphones. And I am the director of Go Productions with this art services organization. I used to work up at the Asia Society and have worked with a lot and traveled a lot in Asia and done Asian and Asian American, producing Asian and Asian American music, dance, and theater for a number of years, over 30 years. And I also manage Yoshiko Chuma and the School of Hard Knocks, which is a performance company based in New York for the last 30 years. Yoshiko is now in Japan, putting together this project, Hold the Clock. We're running, we have an annual season in New York, and it's March 19th through 21st at the 92nd Street Y as part of the Dance Legacy series. The piece is dance and theater based on the novel, a very kind of abstract novel, Sayonara Gangsters, by Genichiro Takahashi, and it's a very, very exciting piece. There will be three artists coming from Japan to be part of the project. The Sing Sizzle of Taka, who's an incredible designer, and Rie Ono is also a designer. And we're working together with people from all over New York and the tri-state area. So this is a new project. There's video, dance, theater, all kinds of, it's a multimedia performance. And I also welcome you to contact me for a discount code. Although the tickets are not that expensive, I think they're $15, which is set by the 92nd Y, which is very nice. And I'm also always interested in collaborating with young artists and finding different people to collaborate with Yoshiko as a choreographer and director, musicians, other visual artists. So if you're ever interested in doing something like that as a performative, please contact me. And I work with Taiko Eitetsu Hayashi, so if there's anything, my website is goproductions.org, and also the School of Hard Knocks yoshikochuma.org, and I'm happy to talk to everybody about that. Thanks. If you have more cards, you want to take them to your venue. Oh, and I brought hummus in here.
Hi, my name is Peter Yip, and I'm a graphic artist for about 16 years, and I fell into silkscreen printing. And first off, I want to thank the Town Hall for hosting these events. It's my first time here. I linked up with the Children's Museum of Arts, and we created this program to teach and educate kids how to screen print. And to teach and educate kids also about the Chinese New Year, which is the Year of the Tiger this year. And it was a great thing for the community to find out more about like the Lunar New Year's and what each animal, what traits they have. So this was our first example. A little scary, but for the boys, they loved it. And the kids, they also had printed these that I was able to take with me. So it was like a little tiger pattern. And they also did this, which is a little bit more advanced. They like put different colors on it and then we're able to blend it. So it was a lot of fun for them. We had ages, it was marketed towards 8 to 12, but we had 5 to 12. And it was great how like these young kids were able to come and be able to learn all about silkscreen printing. And the reason behind it was that right now is like all these budget cuts with the whole education system. You know, they're closing down schools. And as a kid, you know, when you look back, you're like, oh, I remember when I was like 8 years old, I was able to do this painting course and get creative. And now it's like, when they look back, are they going to have that for the future for them? You know, and also at the age of 8 to 12, they're going to decide what high school they want to go to, what college they want to go into, or even like choosing a career choice of being an artist. So in doing this, I want to reach out to the communities of, you know, either different ethnicities and find out like how we can, you know, be able to branch out and teach the kids now so that they have something to look forward to. So if you guys want any kind of information, I have a few pamphlets with me, and you know, definitely love to speak to you how we can make this happen. But thank you for your time.
As some of you know, we've just completed the third cycle of our Urban Artist Initiative grant. It took a long time because it's a collaboration between various different organizations. The Alliance is a steering committee, leader in that, but we also have a partnership with Harlem Arts Alliance, the Bronx Council on the Arts, Queens Council on the Arts. In this last cycle, overall, we received almost 1,000 applications, and more than 300 were actually from Asian and Asian American artists. We were only able to give out 10 of these fellowships, and I think about 4 or 5 of you are here today, so we wanted to take this moment to acknowledge you publicly. I think Mariko is going to release the list here on the screen, and I know that a few of you are here, and if you wouldn't mind just standing up so we can acknowledge you. I know that Golnar Adili is here. I wanted to congratulate you. Bora, have I missed anybody? I don't think so, but we have other artists, Cecile Chong, Amy Cho, Hong Xiong Zhang, Peilin Kuo, and Yisop Yun, who've all made it. It was very difficult, as you know, when we receive grants, we do not make the determinations ourselves. We invite a panel of experts and people from the community who spend an entire day going through just the media applications. So it was a difficult process. A dark arts panel for the entire pool of applicants. And so we are not sure if this fund is going to be available in the future. This is the third year. But we want to, again, acknowledge you publicly and hope that that little bit of money will serve you in your future projects. Congratulations. So now I'd actually like to ask Golnar to come in and pitch. Golnar, followed by Adam, Natalia, and Alex Gray from Fractured Atlas, followed by John Lamb.
Hi, everyone. It's so good to be here. And I feel like I have many more friends that I didn't know before. Today, a new body of work is being shown in 2 different group exhibitions, and one is in the Lower East Side Print Shop, is where I'm a resident right now, a keyholder resident, and half of it is being shown in a one-night show at my friend's concerts. Half of my work, which is being shown at the Lower East Side Print Shop, is going to be on the 24th of March. From 6 to 9, and it's basically based on, it's very biographical, and it's based on a letter my mother wrote to my father in the post-79 Iran, about 25 years ago is when the letter was written, and I do text work, so this is an example. If you want to see text work, come and see it. The concert is Brooklyn Writer on March 15th in the East Village. Brooklyn Writer is an adventurous genre bending string quartet from NYC, celebrates the release of their new album, Dominant Curve, on Monday, the 15th of March at Angel Orenson's Foundation, which is in the East Village. And there's going to be an art gallery, like I said, one night. And the album's centerpiece is Claude Debussy's string quartet in G minor. I don't know anything about music, so I was like, as well as in 2009 by Kojiro Umezaki from Japan, Dmitry Yanov Yavonsky from Uzbekistan, Justin Messina, who's a DJ and electro acoustic DJ composer from New York, and a violinist by the name of Colin Jacobson, and Brooklyn Writer, and they're really amazing. They work with the Southpoint Ensemble. Thank you.
Hi all, again Adam from Fractured Atlas and Alex, and we're so glad to be here today, and we passed out these flyers on your chair We're a national arts service organization with over 11,000 members across the country, all types of artists, and everything we do relates to the business of art, the unsexy side of what you do. So we have low-cost health and liability insurance services. We have fundraising tools like fiscal sponsorship. Thank you, Christine, for the shout-out. We have online education, online courses and videos, and calendars and special offers and things like that. And every Alliance member has access to a free associate membership in Fractured Atlas. So if you'd like to access that, just speak to Nico and he'll give you the proper information. And Alex, what
is it? The only thing I want to say is I'll be at the Personal Finance Workshop for Artists this Saturday, March 6th, which Seema made reference to earlier. So we hope to see you there.
Thank you, guys.
So I'm John, this is Alvin.
Yes.
Okay. We're with Curious Frog Theater Company. We're in our fourth season. We just got our nonprofit status, and our mission is to do traditional and classic works with multicultural casting. So what we're doing is we're opening the doors for, you know, artists to have voices and to kind of just do their work, you know. We also work with creative individuals, you know, directors, designers, choreographers, so, you know, we're always looking for that. Let's see, so our season starts in April. We're actually launching a, sorry, buddy. All right, we're doing the New Work series. So with this, we're bringing in established playwrights to just kind of talk to them and kind of open up the idea of non-traditional casting and kind of get that in their brains and their minds so they can think about that. Then we have the Spring Preview Salon, and then we're doing The Maids. That's gonna be our first show by Jean Genet, and it's rumored that it's gonna be basically a South Asian cast, so it's going to be exciting. Pretty much it.
Great things about theater, Curious Frog as a multi-ethnic theater company is, with the shows that we do, I think it's really important not to run away, like not to just do a show and say, hey, I want an Asian American cast, hey, I want an African American cast, just for the sake of doing that, but also like, because you can't run away from the color of your cast and the color of your actors. You need to do it and find a way to inform what the play is and how it changes a pre-existing play that may not have been written for that demographic. And I feel like this company does a good job of not running away from that and using it to empower the script and empower the message, which I think is one of the great things about this company.
Yes. Thank you.
Invite Pele Bosch from the field, followed by Mana Hashimoto, and followed by Teiji Nagashi.
Yeah. Sure.
Hi everybody, my name is Pele Bosch and I'm associate director at the field. The field is an artist service organization that was founded in 1986, and we offer arts management workshops, creative programs and residencies, fiscal sponsorship, things like that. This is our brochure, and it's over by the chow. So if one of the things that I let you know about is going to be useful to you, please pick it up and check us out. There are three things I want to let you know about today. First is that next Tuesday, we have a workshop called Public Speaking for Artists. I have not taken the workshop yet, so if I do a bad job, it doesn't mean anything, okay? But it's taught by someone who teaches public speaking and is a theater artist and is part of our field family for a long time, Michaela Hall. And it's basically a workshop so that when you come to the next town hall, you can really rock it out and get your message across. It's also gonna be useful if you have post-performance discussions about your work or even if you're in the audience and you want to make a comment on someone's work and you're a little nervous and you want to have your voice be heard. Being able to talk about your work is very important. I think that's why everybody is here. So invite you all to come down. It's next Tuesday at 6:30. Another thing that's happening next Tuesday is we have a deadline for residency applications. We have subsidized space, super subsidized, 3 months of space, April, May, and June. And
there's two programs. One of them has group workshops and culminates at a performance at Dance Theater Workshop, part of their guest artist series. It's a super simple application. It will take you 15 minutes on our website, which is thefield.org. And the last thing I want to tell you about is our field work, which is creative workshops. We have one starting up in April. It's Saturday afternoons, and it's basically a place for a group of artists to meet every week and show what they're working on and exchange feedback. Thank you.
Hi, my name's TJ from Tokyo. I just arrived in New York last night. So I'm a body balance therapist in Tokyo. So I think it is easy to understand what I'm doing. So please see the slide. But this photo shows the ideal posture, which originally designed by DNA. But most of the people goes like this, unbalanced body, because your right and left muscles not put equal tense. Your spine cannot sustain an equal tense, so please press. Then your body has to scream, "Hey master, you have a serious problem with lower back or shoulder." Then press. This is my patient, one of my patients. He has a serious problem in the lower back. Then press. And after just first treatment, he regained the ideal posture. You can see the difference in between before and after treatment. So press. And this is at the time he was 10 years old, he has a serious problem on the back and easy to catch cold, then press. And then after 10 treatments, he regained ideal posture. So his back pain disappeared, then press. This old lady, she was 80 at the time, so she has lower back pain. And after a couple of time treatments of breathing press, never again, and her serious problem disappeared and breathe. And she was difficult to raise his left hand, but now his serious problem is gone. So this is what I'm doing. This is a therapy. The most unique point is no pain, and easy to find out what has changed before and after treatment. Okay, so I'd like you to change your balance. Very easy method, I'm going to show you. So please raise your hand. Yes, please check which hand is longer and shorter. So each other, we check each other. But relaxing. Nico?
How about Nico?
If there is somebody who has a serious problem in the shoulder, stiff shoulder or whatever, you? Okay, so please sit down here. I'm going to show you one more method. Just please sit down and just relax and please raise your hands like this. I can see. Please raise your hand again. Again. Stop for a minute. Which verbal, which shoulder? You?
All over.
Out of my. So which hand is easy to raise up? You feel? Right? If you have the.
Oh my god.
Okay. And please say,
Did you have to fix it in
30 seconds?
Okay.
I need to pick them.
Yeah, it's
equal. It's different, you know? This is the one with the technique. Yes, I have a lot of technique for to change the body. Therapy, please give me a whistle. I'm going to say have a private session until end of April in Manhattan, 48th Street, 8th Avenue. So please give me a whistle.
Okay.
Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mana Hashimoto. I'm a dancer and choreographer. I'm originally from Tokyo, Japan, and basically live in New York. And I do contemporary dance and I videograph in my dance piece. I go to the environment and put the camera on my head. And I dance in the environment, and then in a piece I recreate the environment, how I felt, and the project is, the dance project is, my goal is to beyond our sight and to find a common vision with audience. And I also teach art yoga in Manhattan. We're going to have a special workshop actually with TJF, which performed in wonderful adjustment right now. And the idea of this special yoga workshop is that through TJ's art therapy and connecting the yoga postures, and at the end of the workshop, we'll recreate the ideal body balance, the shape of the body, and then with yoga meditations and the relaxation and the breathing technique. And actually, TJ is also a Native American healer, and we're looking for actually Native American drum so that we could use for the workshop. So if anybody has or had a connection with Native American drum, please let us know. And the and at the end, I would like to share this idea that I would like to organize a dance festival. The idea is like a Paralympic idea, but for people who has different body contents to perform, and eventually I want them to be able to be an independent performing artist, and encourage them and teach exercise, and TJ is also this collaborator to show them the special exercise, so that eventually they will be able to teach the exercise to people who has the same body conditions. And so right now we're looking for the organizations and fundings to expand this idea. And please, and also I'm looking for collaborators for my creations. And I have my website is www.manahashimoto.com. So thank you.
To invite Adolf Alphonse from Holland School of the Arts, followed by and then Una Hall.
I'm just going to pass this around to stick one of these press releases. I don't have any postcards for the upcoming exhibition. These are photographed works, some of them. They're actually pretty big, so we'll talk about that. My name is Adarsh, I'm from Holland School of the Arts. And first of all, I just want to say a special thanks to Nico and Mariko. I know the organization is going through changes right now, but this is such a wonderful event. And Nico with his smooth DJ voice, and Mariko with her Tai Chi, and which I'm sure is coming up, and her constant emails reminding us to come for these events. They're really doing a wonderful job, and I hope you take notice of that. Well, so the Harlem School of the Arts, we have exhibitions as well as classes for students, classes in dance, music, theater, visual arts. So I'm the visual arts director, so I manage the visual arts department and the exhibitions. Been there for about 2 years now, and that's a pretty interesting exhibition. This is an
exhibition we're having next month, or this month actually, Women's History Month. March is Women's History Month, I don't know how many of you know that. And we're having an exhibition of an artist whose work I came across about 2 years ago when I was working for a previous organization called Shoshama. The name of the artist is Eliane Defebaugh, and she makes this wonderful, huge painting. Some of them are 10 feet, 15 feet wide. With a lot of interesting textiles and everything from leopard skin print to some of the screen prints that you showed, all those patterns on there. Very interesting, with different fabrics, velvet, velcro, all of that stuff. And the exhibition opens next Thursday, March 11th. But I just wanted to tell you a little bit about the creative process that we've evolved at the school over the last year and a half. I just don't like turning anyone with a creative potential away. We try to incorporate everyone who has something to offer, some creative talent, and they want to collaborate with us, be it musicians, painters, whoever it is. I encourage you to come to our school, have a conversation with me, see how we can put our skills together to do something. And we don't have a ton of cash to offer, but we do have a stage, we do have a theater, we have good lights. Mics. And anyways, I just wanted to say the exhibition opens on March 11th. That's next Thursday. Please take a press release, a copy of the press release that you have here. And the press release are wordy and ugly, but please come and check it out. That's all you need to know. It's next Thursday, 6 to 8 p.m. Thank you.
My name is Susan Masson, and thank you very much for the Alliance for being here. I'm a physician, and I'm completely awed by being in the presence of many such creative and artistic people. I am here in representing and as a volunteer for a group, the Eastside Institute and All Stars Project, which is co-sponsoring the sixth biannual Performing the World conference gathering, and to invite you all to participate. Performing the World is going to be taking place at the end of September and the beginning of October. It is a very unique gathering, international gathering, bringing people from all the way from business, from education, from therapeutics, from the theater world, to people together, to come together to explore, can performance change the world? Reason I'm here today is because we would love people to submit proposals. The deadline was extended to mid-March, and so if any people here are doing, would like to kind of join that gathering, it's here in New York City, we would love to invite you. Just briefly, Performing the World is now, this is its sixth activity. It's had about 1,500 participants over the years from 35 different countries. People come together. From a young man, very grassroots project, a young man that is teaching street kids to juggle, to perform in the streets of Bolivia, to community organizers from Taiwan who are doing a whole host of different things, including union organizing and going out in the street and doing street performance, to John Oram, who goes into communities and creates community theater. This year, the particular uniqueness of the Performing the World gathering, I think, is it is bringing together political people to see the possibilities, performance in their work to change the world, and performance people to see the political nature of their work to hopefully create a new reality in the world of performance. I think I've spoken to some people here. I think that it has enormous possibilities to bring a cultural dimension into our desire to create a better world, a more humane world, and that's why I'm involved in this. As a physician, I found that performance is enormous to create new things. I have some flyers and we have a website.
Filmmaker. I have an upcoming work in progress screening at the Museum of Chinese in America on March 18th, Thursday evening, 6:30. I'm really close to finishing this documentary about Anna May Wong. Wong. She was the first Chinese-American film star and stage actress who reached worldwide fame and popularity in the 1920s and 1930s. And my documentary is focusing on her heydays of 1920s and 30s, interweaving her personal and private life using her own words. So I'm going to, it's actually, the screening is a free screening and followed by Q&A, so please come and invite your friends. I'm going to show you a 1 minute clip where Anna Mae Wong talk about her film role with her well-known film. It's called Daughter of Dragon from 1931.
Okay, I just want to do an audio test.
So many times older than that of the West. We have our rigid codes of behavior, of honor. Why is that never seen on screen?
Your noble father will receive you.
I got so weary of the parts of...
everybody because it's hard. Yeah. Over there. The Asian Women Giving Circle is a group of predominantly, but not exclusively, Asian American women who have, for the last 4 years, pooled their financial resources, both individually as well as fundraising amongst their friends and networks, and to basically support Asian women artists who are using the tools of the art to support social activism, social equity goals, in particularly affecting the Asian American community. So we're actually in our fourth year as an organization, and right now you can go to our website, which is www.asianwomengivingcircle.org, and you'll see if you click on apply, thank you, we're currently accepting applications for funding, and all the information, I mean, you can download the application also on the website. It gives you a sense of the kinds of work projects, both, you know, individual artist projects as well as organizations that are in some manner using the tools of arts to, you know, influence culture, to build community, ultimately with the social change goal. And as sort of just to piggyback on Susan, you know, we wholeheartedly believe that performance art, that include the time, no, sorry, that performance art obviously is a very powerful medium to influence positive social change. So please just go to the website. All the information is there. The key thing is the deadline is Friday, April 2nd, and it's Pacific Standard Time because our fiscal sponsor is based in San Francisco. So everything goes directly to our fiscal sponsor in San Francisco, which is APIP, Asian American Pacific Islanders in Philanthropy. And then March 17th, there's flyers over on the table for one of our upcoming friend-raising, community-building events, Sip, Shop, and Swap. It's going to be tons of fun. Basically, you bring something in your closet that's nice, that you that you can sell. We're going to organize a little silent auction. It's going to be at a great gallery on the Lower East Side, Bridge Gallery. And then folks will bid, and we'll use that money to support artists and art organizations. Thanks.
Okay, so now it's time for Tai Chi intermission. So if everyone can stand up, we're going to get some blood flowing and some oxygen to the brain. Sometimes when you stand up, the effects of the coffee kind of jolt into you also as well, so we're going to utilize that. I once read from a Budo instructor, and if you can tell me who this is, we can be great friends, but I can't remember right now. But it said that the body is really just a skeleton floating in a sack of fluid, right? So if we imagine our skeleton as really being supported by the fluid in our body and by our muscles, we can begin to imagine a more supple and fluid body. So let's start by just extending our hands out in front of us. Actually, let's start like this. Feet about hips width apart in, and imagine dropping our energy sinking into the core of our body, which is around the abdomen. And when you do that, you're gonna breathe in and then push down and relax a little bit and bend your knees a little bit. So from there, we're going to lift our arms about shoulder height, and we're going to kind of explore the ether around us. I want your hands to be, put your attention in your hands and how they relate to the rest of your body. And maybe just imagine that your energy is extended out through your hand into the space around you. You can even begin to move it and shape it by the palm of your hand. It's really a process of becoming conscious of your body in space and your life energy. So don't forget to breathe. And when you don't forget, your spine is, keep moving your hands, but your spine is going to be a straight shot into the ground, because that's where we get our energy from. The energy comes through.
through the bottom of our feet into our legs and into our spine where we manipulated here. So everything moves in the center of our body. Move a little faster if you like. And then you can go the other way. There's going to be a natural moment where the power will come from the center of your hips and will emanate outwards. And that's the way that your hands change position. It's not merely the strength of your arms, but it's the decision that you make with the core of your body and its ripple effects outward. You can even start to play with it a little more here. If you imagine a ball, I mean, you know, you guys have heard about, you know, energy balls or like fireballs, like those, that idea, I think, you know, originated from this concept. So really, I just want you to become more in touch with your breath. It should push out when you exhale, and when you inhale, it should be your abdomen that's filling rather than your lungs or your chest. So it comes from deep within you. And, you know, as you move through New York and you go on the subway or whatever else you're dealing with, just remember that, you know, our body is very connected to our mind, and try not to become disconnected from your body as it is a tool for you to move through New York. So let's wrap it up by bringing it out in front of us, taking a deep breath, and then letting it drop and exhaling. And that's where your energy should sit the rest of the day. So, thank you.
Don't get too comfortable. I'm going to ask you to stand again in a second. Yeah. classes in the Arabic melodic system at an Arab arts organization called Alwan. It's spelled A-L-W-A-N. Their website is Alwan for the Arts. It's downtown 16 Beaver Street in the Financial District. It's actually Tuesday evening, so if anyone feels like coming tonight, Tuesday evenings at 7:30. My ensemble, Zikraya, we don't have any upcoming performances this month, but we'll be doing April 3rd as part of the Target First Saturday series at the Brooklyn Museum. And we'll have a CD release on May 1st and a bunch of great shows in May. Thank you very much.
We have just a few more pitches to go. We have just a few more pitches to go, but I wanted to announce a new program that we've launched. Some of you may have seen the... this is off too. I just wanted to announce a new program that we're doing. It's a series of workshops. Short of being able to give out money, our re-grants have dried up. We've heard from a lot of artists about, of course, the need for diversifying and sources of earned income and sort of getting into the meat. And the Alliance being based on a sort of peer learning environment, what we've done is a series of workshops called Brainstorm in partnership with New York Foundation for the Arts' Immigrant Artist Project and Queens Council on the Arts. Four workshops this year, 2010. The first one is selling work online. Actually, let me, thank you. The first one is selling work online, and the structure of these is that we have a lead speaker, in this case, Chanel Kennebrew, who is the founder of junkprints.com, who will spend 15, 20 minutes describing how she goes about selling her work online. And then we have other artists and expert discussants who will have some time to chime in and give us their perspectives. Two of the three are actually here today, Hidemi Takagi is right here, and Anwar Hossein, who will come, and they're both working on really interesting projects, looking at social media as a way to get the word out about their work. And so we invite you to come. It's going to be lively. It'll be about an hour, 45 minutes of this discussion, I mean these presentations, and a full hour of Q&A discussion. So it's called Brainstorm because it's got input from the community. This is the first one in the series. It's happening March 18th. I think it's the same date as your event, Yuna. I'm afraid. It's March 18th in Dumbo. The second one will be teaching, again, about the a workshop about integrating teaching to support your career. Kaoru Watanabe, one of our members, will be the lead speaker for that. And in the fall, we'll have one called Self-Producing and another called Touring. So these are the four for the year. We'll continue some more next year, but we haven't done workshops for a long time because all of our partners are doing such great workshops, and so this is the first time in a long time that we've actually decided to produce a series based on what we've been hearing from a lot of you. So please come. There's a sign-up sheet at the table here. It's going to be very lively. We have a lot of great artists with a lot of really good tools, and hoping that this is really a good learning environment for everybody. So please come March 18, selling work online, whether or not you sell work online, because I think there's a lot about social media and using the power of social media to get people to learn about your work also. So please come to that. We have a few more pitches. I think we'll go straight into them. Hollis Bartlett, followed by Jessica from our partners at Life Our Immigrant Project, followed by Avni.
So I'm from a dance theater workshop in Chelsea, and we have a couple excellent performances coming up in March. Some Asian American artists. You want to start with playing the?
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want to introduce
them? Well, I'll speak with them.
So quickly, I came here to announce what Nico already announced and just reiterate that it's going to be really great. Thank you, Anwar and Hidemi, for coming out today. We're going to be doing this workshop on the 18th. We'd love to see you all there. And then we also have kind of our own series as well of workshops coming up for the spring with NYFA Immigrant Artist Project. That's kind of pending. We also have a couple more sort of social, thoughtful panel events coming up too. I'll be back here in April to give you guys more details, but just a heads up, on April 14th, which is a Wednesday, we're teaming up with Opportunity Agenda, who's presenting a big forum on immigrant arts and culture and kind of recognizing the contributions that immigrant Americans have made to American culture, and kind of teaming that up with policy initiatives. I don't know if any of you guys know, but there's been a big comprehensive immigration reform bill introduced recently, and this is kind of part of their effort to recognize all the contributions that immigrants from all different parts of the world have made in an effort to push through reforms in our kind of broken immigration system. And then the next week, NYFA Immigrant Artist Project is actually going to be doing our own panel as part of Immigrant Heritage Week, which is part of the Mayor's Office of Immigrant Affairs as this celebration every year for a week, and celebrates specifically immigrant contributions to New York, to the five boroughs. And we're going to have a bunch of artist presentations and discussion around this topic of how you bridge the divide between contemporary and traditional art, and how are artists of different disciplines kind of transcending that divide. So I'll be back here in April with details about who's speaking, kind of more details on the topic, but I just want to put that on everyone's radar and encourage you all to come out to this workshop on March 18th. Thank you.
So again, I'm Hollis from the Dance Theater Workshop. So we have Kusoja and Yasuko Yokoshi. Kusoja starts tomorrow, March 3rd through the 6th, and she's working with 3D avatar Wii technology to kind of create this movement during the performance. And she's collaborating with 17 different partners ranging from 3D performers, programmers, experimenters. And here's a little preview of the piece.
Sugar the Sound?
Yeah.
Okay, is that the pool?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the second program we have is Yasuko Yokoshi, who starts March 17th through the 20th. And she's working with a kabuki instructor to recreate some old works, some buto works, and also kind of bring them into a more contemporary setting.
Show will be in Philadelphia, June 10th through July 24th. Opening will be on Saturday, July 12th, 6 to 9 p.m. at 12 Gates Gallery in Philadelphia. It's on Cherry Street, so if you're in Philly, please do stop by. And the third one will be in New York, Chelsea, August 3rd to the 24th. And the opening night will be August 4th, 6 to 8 p.m. at the Guild Art Gallery in Chelsea. And I don't have the postcards, I will bring them next meeting, and we'll have the postcards and announcement, and they're printing out catalogs for me, so I'll bring that as well. Okay, thank you.
I'd like to invite Martha from Asian Cinevision. And then I don't know if you are here, please make yourself known. Faye, is Faye here? Veronica, Are you me?
No. Krista. Please go ahead. And after Martha, we'll go into Michael's pictures.
Hi, everyone. I'm from Asians in the Vision. We're from also organizing the Asian American International Film Festival every year, but I'm here to announce our new competition. It's a short film competition, and anyone who's non-professional, aspiring, and emerging filmmaker is welcome to make their 5-minute short film to submit to this competition. And the grand prize is $3,000, so wouldn't we want to have $3,000 to use in this economy? So it could be anything Asian American related. So the deadline is April 30th, so you have more than 1 month to make your little film and submit. And you can see all the details on our website, and here's a little flyer that you can take home. Okay, thank you so much.
So unless I've forgotten anybody from the list itself, I was going to invite anybody who wants to say something. We'll do a micro pitches. Please all come up. And these are 30-second announcements. So I usually just keep this in my hand, actually. But please all come up, and we'll introduce yourself and deliver your pitch. Let's go ahead.
Hi, I'm Simi. I'm Development Director at Lotus Music and Dance. I just wanted to inform you of a couple of things coming up. We have a Sakuhachi meditation. All the flyers are there. Coming up on March 6th, we have a Korean and Tibetan dance program. And then this might be interesting to you. We have Drumful on the Hudson, which is a Native American festival that comes up in May. It's a really big, about 5,000 people in Inwood Park. We're looking for volunteers. If you guys would like to volunteer, or anyone in your organization that you might know, just grab some flyers. And tickets are available online for the two events, and then Drums Along Hudson is a free event up in Inwood Hill Park. Hope to see y'all there.
Hi, everyone. I'm with the River Museum of Art, and I just wanted to let you know that I brought two flyers over there for everyone. The first is our just off the press spring calendar of all our upcoming exhibitions and programs, and then the second is all about our Brainwave Festival, which just launched. It's the third year, and I think it would be interesting to a lot of you in the room. It pairs artists with neuroscientists and astrophysicists, different scientists from different disciplines, all having conversations together about how our brains work and how our brains interpret the world and the universe around us and why. So it's a lot of very interesting art conversations. So this flyer gives you all the dates and all the people, like Laurie Anderson, Charlie Kaufman, Mark Morris, and they're over there.
And your name, please?
Louise Brooks.
Hi, I'm Sandra Solomon. I had a solo show in Williamsburg at the Causey Contemporary Art Gallery in June, and I just wanted to show you one of these pieces. It's called Cloudscapes, and it's they're three-dimensional quilts.
Wow, beautiful.
So, quick setup. And so, some of this work and some other wall pieces. So, this is based on Pajagi, a Korean textile. Sorry. Thank you.
Everyone, I'm Ashok Sinha. I'm a photographer. You might have seen my work in magazines such as National Geo Traveler, PDA, Budget Travel, probably this month. But this time I'm actually organizing a workshop and cultural exchange workshop pretty much in Ecuador, primarily for photographers, but also inviting videographers and writers. We already have a writer. Spots limited to 8 people. We have 4 spots left, so if you're interested, please come talk to me. Thank you. It's in June, 20th to 27th. Thank you.
My name is Alia Alhan. I'm from the Republic of Kazakhstan, and we have Cultural Center of Kazakhstan Incorporated organization. We have a concert on March 27th, Saturday at 5:30 p.m. at Wild Recital Hall, Carnegie Hall. And this is contemporary Kazakhstan music. If you'd like to have more information, it's at our website www.kzculture.com. And I brought today manti. It's a Kazakh dumplings with ground lamb meat and onions. So please welcome to try.
Hi, my name is Kyoko. I'm a representative for Halloween's Alliance today. We're going to have our first international arts event at the Hip Hop Culture Center. And so I have a press release we just released yesterday. So if you need information, please contact me. And also, they're still looking for visual artists. So if you have anything that you want to introduce your visual arts, please contact to Halloween's Alliance. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Maria. I'm a dancer, but I also producing the event, wine tasting event. So this time we're gonna focus on the red wine. So if you love red wine, please come to the event. And then also we have the special guest from Japan. She's a singer, Taeko. She's a gospel singer. So if you're interested in this is international event, so please come and then just have fun. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Kenji. I'm the last minute replacement, so I'm not supposed to, I don't know what I'm supposed to be talking about. Anyways, I guess I'm part of I'm a member of Taikoza, which is a Japanese drumming group. We're performing this coming Sunday at Symphony Space, which is our annual concert at Symphony Space. We usually do it in November or December, but we're touring Switzerland and we went to Russia and Belarus last year, so I guess we kind of pushed back to March. And we are also having a workshop for children March 14th at Bowery Poetry Club. This is for kids. And we're also having a workshop for adults on the 20th at the same place. So, and this is the postcard. If you're interested, thank you.
I think that concludes the town hall. Thank you all for coming. Please stay, have some food and drinks and mingle. If you haven't signed up, please do so. That way we can send the RSVP list to everybody that's outside. And there is also an RSVP for our workshop on March 18th. Please, if you think you might be available, put your name on that and then we'll remind you. Thanks again for coming. Next town hall is, again, it's April 6th, same place, and we'll let you know ahead of time. Thanks again, and enjoy the food and the coffee.